their horses with an orderly at the gate. Anderson and his aide banged at the door of the house and they were let in. Anderson called for Lewis and being told he was not in the house, he said if he was not forthcoming, he would burn the house down, but that if he would make his appearance, his life should be spared. Given this assurance, Mrs. Lewis sent for her husband, who had been upstairs. When Lewis arrived, Anderson and his fiendish associate were at the table, drinking and helping themselves to the food which had been left after the supper. "Here's an old Union man," Anderson said. Anderson laughed, "and I've heard of you. An old Price been hurt down from Arkansas and Texas. You've been more damage to our cause than any 10 men in the state." Mrs. Lewis not allowed to say a word, and Mr. Lewis himself silenced in the moment he attempted to say anything. First thing Anderson did was to demand Lewis money for his knife. Declared he had vast sums of money hid. Lewis gave him about $1,000, telling him it was all he had. This did not satisfy the incarnate devil. Lewis down with a blow to the head with a pistol. This was repeated several times. Both Anderson and his aide mingling blows with blasphemous and obscene curses and yells of the most savage kind. Anderson took Lewis and stood him on his head, doubled him up and jumped on him. Anderson and the captain put muscles on both of their pistols in his mouth at once and crammed them down left them, choking him terribly, asking him, "How'd he like that?" This barbarous act was repeated several times. Anderson also made Lewis stand by the wall and shot his legs across the room, hitting them and asking them tauntingly if he was shot. Once, Anderson called up some Lewis's Negroes whom he had emancipated and asked them, "You have been set free, have you?" Negroes replied, "Yes, you damned old coon, you've set your Negroes free." He struck one of them in the head with the muzzle of his pistol. Anderson and the captain took the Negro girl of 12 and 13 years old into the other room. Both of them ravaged her by turns. One tortured Lewis while the other was committing the outrage on the Negro girl. He placed the pistol to Mrs. Lewis's knee, fired down on the feet and burned it. This he did twice. He also choked Lewis many times, then taking his knife out and seizing Lewis by the neck. He fell with a jugular vein, pricking it with his knife and giving an Indian yell. Said, "This old fellow thinks more of his money than his life, and I'll cut his throat."
Thank you. Shot, melted nail in his hat, and all my bum, bridge, mass, and died, and all that shot, melted. burning and hacking, drinking and spitting. Mad dog cowboys throwing down lid, running and stomping with eyes blood red. 200 men wailing and gnashing, kicking and screaming, beating and bashing.
Some miles east of Albany in the road, 10 or 15 strong. Our advance guard drove them in and through Albany, which is situated in the Missouri bottoms at the foot of the bluffs. The whole command followed up and were dismounted in the south of town, leaving the fourth man to hold the horses, except our advance guard of cavalry, who was sent forward to engage and draw out the enemy. Our infantry were formed into company lines and marched forthwith into the open woods beyond Albany some 400 yards and thrown into the line of battle. Scarcely had the lines been formed when the enemy, who had also been drawn up in the line of battle, from 200 to 300 strong, from 500 to 600 yards from our line, were engaged by our advance. Onward came Anderson and his followers in hot pursuit of our advance guard with such hideous shrieks and fiendish yells that made the very woods ring for miles. Our advance retired to the rear of the infantry line, which opened the way for them. The enemy came on in full charge, yelling like Indians without firing a shot until 75 or 80 yards of our line. When the firing commenced on both sides, it was kept up without ceasing with great fierceness until the enemy came within 40 or 50 yards of our line. Anderson and some 5 or 6 of his associates in crime came dashing considerably in the advance of their line and chieftain. With one other, charged fearlessly through our lines and with both unhorsed closed in the rear. Anderson falling dead upon the ground and 20 yards of our men having received 2 balls in his left side of his head near his ear. The others raised and scrambled off into the field to our left. There is found next day. The enemy, seeing their leader fall, could stand no longer but fled into the wild confusion and returned home. Anderson rode a fine iron gray mare with a human scalp tied to the headstall of his bridle.